at the end of the last video, I told you I was going to fix this guy's head in the next one. Well, I lied. I'm going to fix this guy's head instead. And the reason I'm going to do that is because there's a faded area in his shirt that requires a different technique I haven't showed you how to do before. So I'm just going to do him. I'm not going to show you guys how to fix every single blemish in this photo. I'm just going to try and keep it streamlined down to just certain techniques and show you the before and after results. I'm going to fix all the damage you're looking at on his face with the clone tool using the number 2 brush with a hardness of 0.075, and I'm just going to skip ahead to the one part where I did something different with the clone tool that I haven't shown you before. This is what I'm doing different with the clone tool. I'm changing the opacity. Sometimes when you're working with it, you know, you steal color from around the area where the damage is, and sometimes when you're working with it, one area is too light and another area is too dark. So you go to the darker area and then you adjust the opacity of the brush and play around with it, and eventually you'll find the shade that you want. Another way to do it is use a brush with a really soft edge, but sometimes the opacity is the better way to go. I'm going to choose the heal tool. It looks like two band-aids. Going to come over here and do control click and choose this dark area, and then come over a little bit and drag. It works similar to the clone tool, except instead of copying one area to another, it does some kind of blend thing. I don't know exactly how it's or what it's based on, but it does a blend and it'll smooth out these areas that are dark and light and make them blend into one another. I've got my angle lined up so I'm parallel with the jawline, and I'm going to drag, and then I'm going to come over here by the collar and choose another area, control click, and line up so I'm parallel with the collar and drag. I'm going to do this to the whole neck area, and then I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. This is before and this is after the heal tool. The colors are more blended together. It's just smoother looking. I use the heal tool over his eye on the left, and I'm going to undo it and redo it so you can see the difference. It just has a much smoother look. And here's the guy in the middle's head before and after. Not too bad. In the next video, I'll show you how to use a mask to fix this fascia board and this light spot in this guy's shirt. We're going to use a mask and the opacity setting so some of the details show through from underneath. Well, that's it for this one. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. I hope you learned something that'll help you out. Thanks for watching. God bless. Bye.